What is the place of marketing in business? Now, we all know that the environment that we are in is very dynamic. Yeah? Very, very dynamic. In fact, the environment that you're operating in is such that you're getting competitors right center. Who would have thought, for example, that M-Pesa would be competing with banks? Anyone? Nobody. In fact, many people, many banks embraced M-Pesa, isn't it? But now look, they are now competing against each other. The environment is very, very dynamic. And competition has become hyper. Competition is stiff. And only those people who are strategic will survive in this market. Only the strategic, even in life, you've got to be strategic to survive. Consumers are becoming more enlightened. And people switch every other time. Just ask yourself for a moment, how many phones do you have? Lines. How many have Safaricom? You lift your hand, I'm a teacher. Oh. How many have Safaricom? Down. How many have Airtel? I'm telling you, down. Which is L? How many have Telkom for data? How many have you? Let me first say, how many have you? You. Aye? You are Kuna? Huh? They were bought. Equitel? Yeah? So customers have become more enlightened. They can switch the products anytime. And therefore, if you have to survive, you have to be very strategic. One of the strategic writers said that strategy without tactics, this is very important. Strategy without tactics is the slowest route to victory. And tactics without strategy is the noise before death. Are we together? Many marketers are good in tactics. Someone has come up with a product, and then they agree and say, now these guys, we need to go head on. We need to do guerrilla marketing. Big words. And then they realize it's not working. I remember the U guys. They came and said you can call for free. You remember? At U to US? Why are you not in U? Ask them me. Why are you guys not in U? M-Pesa? You are equal to U money? Yeah? So things are changing. Yeah? And because of that, the traditional ways of doing things will not work in the current environment business that we are in. It's either you change the way you do things or close shop. Tell your neighbor that. Remember, I'm a pastor. Tell your neighbor. You either change your way or close shop. You know, some of you use the notes that we gave you in first year to refer. Eh? Maggie, I hope you don't do that. You know, those notes that were principles of marketing. What is marketing? Marketing is blah, blah, blah. What are the four P's of marketing? You don't even know they became 13. You are still talking about four P's of marketing. Yeah? You either change the way you do things. Traditional way of doing things will not work. Yeah? I like what Marketing Society of Kenya says, that the force behind every business is marketing. But I'm now saying it is not just marketing. It's strategic marketing. How strategic are you in your marketing? Now, customers are demanding more and they are becoming more knowledgeable. Now, as marketers today, you need to embrace strategic marketing among many other concepts. Strategic marketing is a unit, by the way, that is taught in the university, especially in masters. But that's not what I'm teaching today. I'm being real and being practical. Yeah? And the question is then, if we say that marketing is this important, any organization, private, public, when things are thick, what budgets do they cut? Why marketing? Yet it is the force behind every other business. Ask your neighbors that you are. Nation, do you ever cut marketing budget? Ama nyi mko sawa? Mko sawa? Pesa iko? Yeah? The reason why many organizations think that sometimes when they give too much money to marketers is a waste of their money is because they think marketing is an operational thing. Marketing is not operational. Marketing is not where you just have a desk and people come and, you know, and you start telling them about your product. That's not marketing. In fact, some institutions think that marketing is putting an ad in NTV. By the way, they say we have really marketed. Why are we not having sales? Then you ask them, why have you marketed? To go NTV, to go Citizen, to go Kameme, to go K24. Why are we not selling? Have you had people say that? Yeah. Because to them, marketing is advertising. And it is good we have a speaker on advertising. Some people will tell you, we have done so many t-shirts. We are branded. Even they even have a day for branding. Hello? Fridays. I don't know. Come back. How come why the... There's someone here who is laughing. I don't know why. Yeah? And they tell you, we have really been marketing. Even on Fridays. We are branded. And then they mention, and if you don't come branded, you're thrown out. Yeah? And for them, they are really marketing. Are we together? Others will even brand their cars and say, hey, sisi tuko marketing kila mahali, tukienda Gikomba iko, ukienda wapi gari yetu. Those are tactics. Yeah? And before I go into details, I urge you marketers, take your place in the boardrooms. Take your place. Things happen in the boardroom. When I was in the private sector, I don't know whether it has changed. Marketers and finance people always used to fight. I don't know why. And they still do. I could not understand. You remember, I'm a bachelor of commerce person, so I know I'm half finance and accounting and half marketing. And Kalombo was right. I got a first class, meaning I'm good in everything, isn't it? Hello? So I used to ask myself, why is it that I'm bringing you money and you can't give me 500 back? And he tells me, go and write, you take for approval. I don't know. I'm like, I'm not selling today. And then my time, there was also a lot of fight between a marketing manager and a sales manager. I don't know whether you started combining. Do you combine these days? I remember the salesperson would be asked in the boardroom, why are you not selling? And then they'll say, people are not marketing. Then the marketers ask, so why are you not marketing? Then they say, these salespeople are not aggressive. We are marketing. Operational. So as marketers, we need to change the way we do things. Okay? Now let's go to strategic marketing. Now, what is this strategic marketing that you're talking about? You are all learned, so I'm trying to make it very different because I know you're learned people, masters people, so I don't want to repeat what your teacher said. This is a very difficult thing for me to do today because I don't want to repeat anything you write in a book. Now, when you talk about strategic marketing, the question you need to ask yourself is, how well do you utilize your resources? Did you know you can have a lot of resources, but you don't utilize them? We have great marketers in organizations who are not utilized, especially in public institutions. Yeah? People have this idea that, it's interesting, I heard the speaker say that corporate is different from marketing, which is true, but most people actually think corporate is the same with marketing. So when you have issues, they tell you go to the corporate office, they will sort you out. You go to the corporate guy, he's like, sini mewafanyia brochure, ni nini mnataka? You need, strategic marketing is about utilizing your resources to achieve your goals. It is adapting your marketing mix elements to your environmental forces. You know Bestel, sindio? You? Steve, I know you know. What is Bestel? A tea political? At the person? Oh. Yeah? Now, organizations that embrace strategic marketing look at the organization from the customer's point of view. Time is gone when people used to have products and give them to people. Just, you either buy or stay. Even if you are monopoly, even Kenya Power these days does not tell us that. Because we have options. Oh, if there's no power, what else do you use? Solar. If there's no solar? Huh? Huh? Torch. You are very right, by the way. Yeah? So, you need to understand that you need to look at your business from the customer's point of view. And that's why I was saying, if wana? Oh, wana base. Now, you see also where I come from is a problem of this one. Whatever. They need to understand their institution from the customer's point of view. I'm imagining someone coming to my office with a, I normally tell my students, with a torn trouser. And you tell me it's fashion. I'm not sure I'll listen to you. Yeah? Now, when you talk about strategic marketing, you're saying that you're focusing on your long-term vision. Remember I said, organizations that are too tactical are just making noise before death. It's always important for you to actually ensure that you combine strategy and tactics at the same time. So when you look at your long-term vision with the aim of having a competitive advantage, that is very important, through innovation. Marketing today is about innovation. How innovative is your marketing department? Just imagine for a moment if M-Pesa decided to leave it at that, where you can only send money. What would have happened by now? Talk to me now. If M-Pesa decided to leave it at just sending money, what would have happened by now? And here is his keyboard. Dead. Or maybe overtaken. Yeah. So the question you need to ask yourself in this room as a marketing person, what do you do that is different from your competitor? Competitive advantage is what you use to outperform others. Why would I go to NTV and not, which one do you like? NTV. Eh? At which one? Huh? The key what? Okay, B. Well. You only have said, God, you watch a manel. Yeah? And by there, I should give examples with media, because they will not take me anywhere. I'm they will sue me. Yeah? Yeah, look at the one they are talking about, not me. They are talking about. Are we together? Why is it that it has not grown like the rest? Yet, it has been there for a long time. I keep asking myself, supposing citizen, are you here? There they are pretending so that I don't say bad things, okay. Supposing the citizen decided, they normally say that they are the most watched, isn't it? So the question is, supposing they decided not to go into the local programmings and all those things, would they be surviving? So NTV, why are you not having a Kiembu channel? NTV? Now I'm challenging you, but no, I'm being very serious, but I'm very serious. You see, when a marketing person goes to Royal Media has more things to offer. I'm just being honest. Eh? Sorry, I'm being very honest. There are more things to offer probably than any other station. Because they'll tell you, if you want to speak to people in Embu, you go to Wemwaro. Me, I come from the marginalized place. So that's another thing. Yeah. So if you want to go to Embu, Wemwaro. If you go to Meru, ni Muga. Muga ni yao. If you go to Jui, where are Amogi? Now, that is being strategic. They have even gone ahead. Allow me to use this as in for now. They have gone ahead, for example, and have Fiu Sasa. Is it called Fiu Sasa? Fiu Sasa. Eh? Which is disrupting their own business, actually. But that disruption, because of innovation, is still bringing money to them. They have gone ahead to make sure that all the tunes that you need, now they even have a tune of the national anthem in your language. See, they are called skiza tunes. You know, sometimes I call people and I'm like, I can't give this one a job. even your phone should be strategic, hello? Surely, how do you call someone and they're looking for work and then the phone starts, rubbish, rubbish, rubbish. People are so unstrategic, honestly. There's one I called yesterday, I thought I had done the wrong. You know, it's like, sichukui simu yako, sichukui simu yako. What I'm saying is, as a marketing person of today, you need to start, you need to stop doing things the old way. Yeah? You need to innovate. You need to do things differently. Even as universities today, most universities today are struggling because they have refused to be innovative. The universities that are making it today are those that are innovative. Our mantra is in my university is riding on technology. Huh? We ride on technology. We innovate on those issues. Yeah. So the question you need to ask yourself as a strategic marketer is, what kind of competitive advantage? What is it that you do that nobody else does? You know, you could be doing the same things but do it differently. That song they were singing here, I can assure you, if I was not a pastor, and they played it here, we sing with Mr. Murray, our dancing would be very different. Are we together? But the song is the same. It's just the way, you know, first of all, they're having torn trousers. I can't wear that. Eh? So maybe even as pastors, we need to change the way we preach. Maybe. But you see, the Bible says that the word of God remains the same. Hallelujah. Eh, so. Yeah? Now, for you to be a strategic marketer, you need to understand your competitor and you need to understand yourself. Most organizations don't even know who they are. I can assure you. You ask them, so what are you up to? They're like, you know, we do many things here. That's the way they say. We do very many things here. So you ask, which many things? Unajua, vile hii economy iko, lazima ufanye vitu mingi. It's true, but what do you do here? First, understand yourself. Then understand your competitors. And you need to understand your competitors are current and potential. Many times when we are coming up with strategic marketing plans or marketing plans, many of us only look at the current competitors. They never think of the potential competitor.